Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to the Champion Circuit for the side of Europe. My name is Rainday, and of course, I'm joined by Hi-Rez Pretty Hair today. We saw a great set with Burrito going against Viral, and Burrito getting the better of Viral pretty convincingly.
Yeah, to be expected there, but I like that Viral was making adjustments. They weren't just, you know, giving up. They were fighting. They fought
exactly.
The whole time, and
exactly.
I want Kings of the North to do the same thing here.
Yeah.
You know, they are going up against, they haven't found a win yet, going up against Burrito.
That's true.
They need to look to improve here. What can they improve in the draft? Can they take something away from Burrito? You know, Burrito's probably going to be looking to pick something spicy here, so we might see Kings of the North actually take some points off Burrito today.
It'll be interesting. Of course, you mentioned Burrito, Kings of the North. They're going up. They're going to be our second match here. Kings of the North find themselves at the bottom of the Champion Circuit. Does this have come into play with you're playing against the top dog and you're the bottom seed? Is there a mentality thing that comes in here?
Respect them, but look to get better. That's
okay.
How you improve at anything. You have to play your betters here. And as we get into the map screen, we see the Kings of the North electing to ban out Serpent Beach. Burrito going with the Ice Mines, and Timbermill will be the first map played today.
So I was kind of curious why we didn't see this earlier on, right? Because Knessa, Laizy, they love this Timbermill map, but we saw the strategy kind of come back to bite certain teams who chose this because the Knessa was baited out as a pick, and then they picked the Eevee, the Androxus, the champions
even
to
the
counter
buck.
That. Even the buck to counter the Knessa, almost like, go ahead and take it. And let's move into picks and bans. This is going to be exciting as we move into seeing just who the teams will elect to play.
Yeah, Knessa here, we highlight this pick often on Timbermill. It's going to be kind of the crux. If they're able to kind of take it, give it away, give it up, counter pick it. It'll be interesting to see what Burrito elects
there
to do.
It is.
They love
There's
to play
the Knessa.
It, though, man. They love to
Laizy
play it.
Laizy will be on his Knessa. So the sniper comes out on the side of Burrito. This will be exciting.
Yeah.
He's one of the best we know in the world at this champion. It is absolutely nuts. And, of course, you see Eevee on the side of Kings of the
response.
North. They're ready. They're saying, okay, we know you're going to pick it. Your first pick, we're going to pick that Eevee. And I would not be surprised to see a tank here, but they go for the dual flanks.
Yeah, they're shutting this down.
It's tough because now...
The police, dude. They're coming.
They're ready. They got the Eevee and the Androxus. But looking
That's
at
fine,
this...
fine, you know? Like, if Kings of the North have one clear objective, if they're not going and saying, hey, we're going to beat Burrito today, this is the day, we're turning it around. If they can just go in saying, hey, we're going to play well against this part of their comp. We're going to do well against Laizy. We're going to focus on shutting him down.
Yeah.
Can we make a plan? Can we draft around this plan and execute it?
Burrito, they are somewhat of a mastermind collective there.
Yeah.
They have their strategies really locked in and practiced. So I'm sure they were anticipating this. So I'm kind of curious how Burrito is setting this all up. They have first pick. They were able to go ahead and make this all happen.
Coming
so
out swinging.
I'm a little scared that Kings of the North are kind of walking into where Burrito are saying, come on,
yeah.
Walk here. Yeah, Eevee Androx is perfect.
Yeah, we'll
Buck,
pick Knessa.
Yeah, yeah.
We'll
Buck,
pick her.
Okay,
we'll
come
pick
on.
Her.
Buck gets selected there on the side of them as well. So three flanks dealing with that one damage champion.
I'm excited to see what Laizy does on Knessa in response to this.
Yeah.
Fernando is going to be hovered and locked in for Burrito. As well, we still haven't seen a tank come out for Kings of the North here. If Burrito get Makoa as well, ooh,
I love it.
Dama, the snack.
I love it.
This is good because he's able to stay at range and keep wherever Laizy has to run. He's gonna know he's gonna have a heal wherever he needs to retreat.
I love it, and it's also a great counter to this Makoa Ying because Ying and Makoa, they're gonna want to sit on that point while the other team of Kings of the North is basically aggressing on the Laizy. But that Maldamba guard now that it's gotten so much of a buff.
Yeah.
It's going to do so much more work on them.
Definitely. You're going to be doubled in damage, and I believe 80% buff to his healing. So it's 280 healing a second, and I believe 400-ish, somewhere around there, per second for that Gord. Spunkki, going to be the one to watch here with this new and improved Mount Domba. It wasn't like Mount Domba was even in a bad spot, though. This is just going to be a hard improvement for this character.
Oh, it's hard. It's hard. He's going to actually be able to heal up his teammates from 200 to 280, and his damage is going to go from 100 to 200 per second when he throws his gourd down. So it's going to be incredible to see all that.
Yeah, so riding along with him, you're going to see some Nimble come out for Bird on this Trail Quest. What this does is... I feel like it adds to what Propel does. You know, it just gives you're starting your thrust with more momentum.
Mm-hmm.
You're able to cover more ground here immediately. Spunky's just going to be chilling out on Laizy right now, sitting on the high ground.
First
blood, though, SunCommander Gonna keep his boy Laizy safe, taking out Plazebo. A little bit of a roster switch up as well. Faenex gonna come in as well for Kings of the North.
He's actually gonna come down, and there's the headshot onto the Makoa. He's looking around. Look at that! The damage from Laizy. The snipe is gonna go true onto Minshmeyer, and that's gonna be the sub getting taken down. Actually, not the sub, excuse me. He's gonna be the main roster player here for Kings of the North. Gonna get taken down on the Ying, and Laizy doing Laizy things.
Oh, God, Bird finding a nice rocket there into the face of that Eevee. We're seeing the Hunters become the hunted here. Laizy winning that matchup. Mm-hmm. They're finding the shots onto Eevee. They're moving forward now. Plazebo with that new Trigger Man buckskin. Look at Soulfly there. But he's going to be taken down by Laizy once again here. Laizy with another kill here.
Wow.
This Kinesa is going uncontested right now.
A double kill on the Laizy, but he's going to get pulled by the Makoa, but three in a row from the man Bird in the air, playing on that Drogos is going to help secure the kill with Thiel following up on his loved Fernando now at this point. The three flankers are just falling like crumbles from a cookie on the floor, having no way to impact this fight except just die immediately and add another kill on the Laizy and the boys.
This isn't what I wanted to see, man. They drafted all the hard dive. Let's see. Let's go get that kill on Kinesa. You've got to execute your strategy. You've drafted for it. You have to follow this up. Get one thing done here, Kings of the North today. Follow up on this draft. Laizy, you cannot let him do this right now.
Oh.
Finding the kill finally goes down after overextending a little bit there. SYER going to pick that one up.
Beautiful plays there as well. And you see, obviously, ooh, Bird getting out
slippery.
Of harm's way. He's very, very slippery. And Pontamba throwing the gourd down, just
yoink,
helping his homie out, and then hitting him with some Mending Spirits. The hit scan heal is going to help clean up, ooh, the carry from Burrito, and there it is. Bird going into the Dragon Punch. He wants a juicy target. He's going for one. He's going to find the Makoa, and that's the juice he needed.
He's not able to get that thrust reset, though, with the kill. Laizy able to pick up Minshmeyer, though, shutting down all the healing. Objective is closing in. Such a narrow window. Still a minute left. Burrito can drop one, maybe two fights, but they won't even do that. Laizy with a double kill to help close out that first push. 2-0 in favor of Burrito.
That's it. It's so amazing how we've seen Burrito just dominate this performance just from the outset. They realized that, okay, you're going to pick the flanks, but I don't know, Nick, what do you think about this actual composition? Do you think this actual composition really does work? I mean, it feels like it lacks a lot of sustain on the point. Even
though
you've got the Yang,
that's what I'm saying. If they drafted to do this one thing, and then they don't play to that strength, it's like, why draft it there? Because we see District 69 pick this comp as well against Laizy's Kinesa. They had the Eevee, they had the Buck, they had the Androxus, they had the dive, and they were diving him. They were finding the kill. Even if they lost the fight,
right,
they found Laizy. That's the point here with this comp. If you're going to draft this, you have to stick to it and execute at what this draft excels at.
Well, Laizy, he's only one player, and he's also got several players just sitting by him. They know this sniper's so important. They're literally going to put a Maldamba right next to him, and already he's gotten 1,100 damage out on the fight. The Oppressor Minds come out, and he's looking for another one. Trigger Man Buck jumps on. He activates the ult, and Laizy's going to transport her out of there, and he's going to basically scope in and scope out looking for the damage, and Buck could go down here, and he does. Laizy gets the kill on a Plazebo after he was the one being hunted down.
Yeah, Thiel picking up SYER as well. Faenex able to find their first kill of the round onto SunCommander, but he will drop to Laizy as well.
There, Thiel, he's going to help his team get 30% and counting on the capture point. It's 2-0 for Burrito. A nice fireball, do some extra damage, but not enough. And he's in a little bit of a difficult place. He's got a shield up, he's got a charge. He's looking
to waste time
and a really good hook going to help make sure that his life pool ends quickly as the ultimate comes out from SYER.
Laizy's gonna be dropped there now. Feel likely to fall, gets the shield up one more time with the heroic leaf damage circumventing the shield, able to take him down. Objective goes to Burrito with that forward zone. They bought so much time.
That's it. That's all they were looking to do, just buy some time. SYER gets out-traded with Bird in the air, so the Dragon gets the better of that one, and the King of the Skies remains the one with the jetpack. And here we go, Laizy looking for a couple of kills. He's looking, and I cannot believe this movement. I can barely see what he's doing, but somehow he's hitting the shots. He's going to press her mind up in there just in case he's going to slow down his targets, and look at that, perfectly timed.
In the wormhole.
Already anticipating where the Eevee was going to be and where she will be.
Boom!
And that's the kill! See you later, buddy. God. Laizy takes down Faenex.
Steps a big toe out into Lazy's view and just gets immediately crushed. now he's got a beat on Sire on this high ground. Sire's afraid to move out from this
box.
Look at this.
He doesn't want to go away from the box.
He knows. He sees him there, but he buys time for Buck to get in his face in the back line there. Will it be enough here?
Oh my god.
Eats another shot. Cannot afford to take another one. It's going to be Bird, there, covering Lazy's backside, taking down Plazebo on the front side of the spite. Spunkki continues to win this for Burrito
on
this Maldamba.
It is almost push, Nick. It's almost push. There's the Wagona, and there it is, the ultimate from Maldamba. It's going to do so much work. 1 minute and 20 seconds. This could be the game already. Don't give Laizy Kinesa on Timber Mill, because you already know what's going to happen.
He couldn't even execute, taking him out with the Buck, with the Androxes, with the Eevee. They had all the tools to do it. We never saw them just get together and go for it.
I mean, that was extraordinary. Just looking at some of those peaks, you just step the big toe out. You know, you just step a little big toe out. Hey, are you home? Boom! It just gets
Sire's
taken
behind the
down.
Box, like,
I can't move. I don't want to move.
Help.
It's amazing.
Team.
Help me, I'm trapped. But he ends up avoiding that one, but they don't avoid the loss to Burrito. It was a fantastic performance, and of course, put Laizy on Kinesa, and you're almost guaranteed to win. And with that Maldamba support coming in, the new champion in Paladins, he's showing that he could have a really good presence on the battlefield.
Definitely. So as we head into these final scores, we're able to see how much work he was able to get done. 27K. But some of the big talking points here is going to be Bird and SunCommander breaking 40K here. This is a little bit to be expected as they were clearly not the target of Kings of the North's aggression here. And they were just able to capitalize. This is what comes with it there. Bird and SunCommander are the ones that are going to step up. When they're not under fire there, you can best believe that Bird is with Laizy, covering his back, killing all of his aggressors.
Absolutely. And so let's get into the maps and take a look at where they're going to be playing next. We were on Timber Mill. We know Ice Mines and Serpent Beach have been banned out. And so it looks like Frog Isle will be the place that the teams elect to play. So this, again, some more open spaces. Kinesa is sometimes drafted here. She's very viable. This is one of the few maps that she actually has a very good advantage because of the long lines of sight. But I'm not sure if they're going to let it happen here on the side of Kings of the North.
Yeah, we'll have to see what just select they want to pick here on this map. I wouldn't be surprised if we saw Laizy run the gauntlet here, not really picking up that Kinesa. He's got so much in
their
Burrito has so much in their champion pool here. I'd be very surprised to see if they go with something similar.
It'll be interesting. He's got their first pick. They're hovering over it, and there's the Eevee on the side of Burrito.
Just as scary, man.
Running the gauntlet, you take away the Kinesa, and then you just get the Eevee. I don't see Kings of the North picking up a Kinesa here. I'm not sure if they will. I think they're going to go for probably a little bit more sustain than they had last fight. It didn't seem like the Makoa and the Ying were enough for them, but they do draft the Ying again, wanting to take that away potentially from a potential Barrack Ying pick that Burrito could have done this next turn.
That's right here. I see, despite the Drogos being on the other team, I wouldn't be surprised to see a Fernando here. The Cassie also made a lot of headway in that last game here, but it will be the Androxus locked in almost immediately. And the Fernando is hovered on. This is a good map for him as well. His shield able to cover a lot of those long sight lines there, shutting down a lot of what Kings of the North will be looking to do.
So Burrito still don't have a support. They've got a support on the side of Kings of the North. They've got a damage, but they don't have a front line. Makoa, Barrack, what are you thinking?
I'm thinking they're definitely might be going to take a Grok here as their healer, especially with Fernando. We're seeing Thiel, and even Laizy plays the Grok sometime. He's likely to be on the Eevee this game here.
Gotcha.
It could be Bird playing that pocket healer style. He's very comfortable playing on the point.
Mm-hmm.
You know, despite he has a Drogos in his god pool. Bird's very good at making those hard switches from flanks to tanks to healers. He can kind of do anything. He's got the mentality switch there.
That's true. Very true. And here it is, the Maldamba again. So we're going to get to see this champion in action. It seems like Spunkki has found his rhythm. I really love playing him. He's one of my actually favorite champions already. He's a lot of fun. And we can't forget he's got those stuns as well. Maybe some resiliences if he goes off on that. And there's Barrack. So they've got the Barrack, the Ying, and the Makoa. It's looking a little bit more death ball-y on the side of Kings of the North. So we'll see if the new champion is going to be the actual counter. I think it is, to the death ball.
Yeah, that Gord buff definitely going to be the one to watch here, as it has been increasing all sorts of output. Going to be doing everything to break up that death ball here. Immediately we're seeing three havens per team, four havens now for Kings of the North come out in response. They do not want to be taking all that damage from Bird, Spunkki, and SunCommander left uncontested. We'll shred you with Victor.
Surprised we don't see aggressions here, though.
Yeah, I mean, it's real talk. Best card. Where's Sky?
Where's Sky and aggression? That's where I think Kings of the North can bring this fight back. I'm just kidding. But truly, though, the thing is that with these havens, aggression has a relatively interesting place to where if the team is mitigating a damage that's not yours, it could potentially be viable, but obviously there's a lot of better choices that we all consider in this. There's the guard. It's going to come down and help keep Thiel alive, and that's actually going to help the trade out. SunCommander's going to get the kill, the double kill onto the Barrack and the Drogo. Sire following back with Laizy, but now Bird's in the air, and this is Snowball and Drox this time. He wants one. He's looking for more, and he gets pulled by the Makoa. And
damn,
that will end his hunt.
No cooldowns available to him, but almost got that reversal up there with that Seething Hatred, running that CDR-centric build. 66% already for Burrito. They're climbing, but Kings of the North are at 5 right now. They are waddling their way back in. SunCommander's going to be hooked in. Sire's going to pick him off, and it's a great start to a fight for Kings of the North.
I really like this as well. It seems like they forced Thiel out. He's going to heal up thanks to the Gort, though. That does a lot of healing, and he's keeping his teammates alive. Spunkki in the back line, although Maldamba is doing work. He gets the kill onto Sire as well. So not only is he healing, he's killing the Voodoo Master, doing his voodoo magic, and now it looks like Thiel is alive and ready to run rampant. He's not going to heal up off of any last stand card that he's got, but hopefully that Gord is going to keep him alive, and it does. Spunkki comes in with the second kill of this fight, and 99% is going to help this overtime tick and secure it for Burrito.
Yeah, Laizy and Bird combining on the back line, finding a lot of clutch picks, and they're keeping the point pressure minimized from Kings of the North here. 2 minutes and 20 seconds remaining, all the time in the world left to push this one. And it looks like Kings of the North are immediately just sticking around their base. They want to dig in hard here and just give up 75% of this push.
They really do, and they're going to let it happen, but they want to make sure that they could at least stop it at one point. Better to give up a little bit and not give it all up than to basically go ahead
an inch,
and
though,
you give them an inch. That's right. That's the risk that they run. Letting them push past this initial choke is definitely not giving them that second defensive opportunity. And here's the accursed arm. Can he hit it? Bird is in the air, and he got three. God will kill. We'll go back to base, and so will Bird as well, thanks to the help of Sire, who's going to clean that up. But Spunky's still alive and fresh. This Dragon Punch could mean a lot. He's going to get one, potentially, but it's going to run out in time.
Nerf.
The duration nerf is going to nerf him, and he's going to go back to base.
Faenex taken down by SunCommander there. Plazebo trying to do what he can right now, but he's under pressure from SunCommander, who is now sitting uncontested in the backline. Laizy finds the final pop shot onto Plazebo, trying to stabilize right now. On the front line is Menchmeyer, hiding under this lockdown. 6 seconds of peace will be found for the boys of Kings of the North. They're a nice hook. SunCommander gonna be taken down, but not before he trades out with God Will Kill.
They're all up doing the Spunkki got up there somehow, and he's just up and basically shooting that snaky snake down onto Menchmeyer, and there is nothing they can do. That defense is going to go down. The sustain is too much. Bird's in the air now. He wants
nice
to get poked, but he jukes out God Will Kill, and that's bad news for the Kings of the North. They're looking more like princes right now as Burrito continues to push. 46 seconds left, but they don't need it. They're going to go ahead and convert this one.
I don't know if I like the idea there to just give Burrito 75% of the push there and just dig it in your base. You put yourself in a spot where if you lose one solid team fight, you're going to give up a round right then and there.
Yeah, I mean, that's the risk you run, and obviously they were hoping for the reward on that side.
Always are.
But it didn't show up. I mean, if you're Kings of the North as well, do you take these aggressive routes? Do you think, okay, we play it safe, we have a good comp, we can win off this, we just need to get rid of Spunkki, who seems to have died at the end of that round, but was incredibly effective for Burrito, and we got to get rid of Thiel. He's been just a monster for them.
Yeah, always in their face, always ever present, Fernando. Burrito does a great job with Fernando. This is an extremely dangerous pick for them, just pressuring out the back line constantly there. What I really want to see is God Will Kill on this Makoa, locking down Laizy time and time again. I want them to make him priority number one. We're seeing him already blink in. They're able to take him down, doing just that. Menchmeyer wipes Laizy off the board there. SunCommander able to answer back, avenging his teammate, but Spunkki finding the next kill in the fight. Answering back, though, will be Sire. Sire with a double kill right now. SunCommander able to answer back onto Faenex right now. It is Burrito currently in control of the point, but not with any tanky presence. It's just SunCommander and Spunkki on this Maldamba, on this Victor, but charging forward now with the Ancient Rage. Landing a hook will be God Will Kill, trying to close out the fight.
I don't know. That was an interesting Ancient Rage. It did not get any kills, and that's kind of a problem. They still have all of their members, and there is no ultimate on the side of God Will Kill, so he's going to have to get some clutch pulls, and he misses that one. Goes into danger as well, and you know who's there. It's Thiel with that constant Fernando pressure.
Turtle soup there on the point will be made. Laizy in the back line, just everywhere, dude. I don't know how this kid doesn't get dizzy. Finds the pop shot around the corner, takes out Sire. 51 points, climbing ever higher. More and more pop shots. Burrito control of the point, control of the zoning.
Nice ice block.
Everything is firing for Burrito.
They're just doing so well. Whoa! There it is. Laizy's going to get taken down by Faenex. Surprise, bro. And I'm coming for your friend, too. Blue team, get the objective. So Burrito still capture it with the zone being effective. It did its job, but not without a couple of cool plays going to Faenex.
All right, so Bird. We'll answer onto Menchmeyer right now. 304 Burrito. They're going to move forward. I like this play this time. A nice hook there onto the Androx. Are they able to capitalize there? Bird able to another step around the corner there. Will be able to just drop down on to the low ground there, but he gets exploded off the map. They're likely to come out with the disengage. He's floating. He's trying to get that another step cooldown back up, and it looks like he does. Up on the map once again is Bird with a nice save.
And there was the ultimate by Ying as well. So it seems like they took your advice, Nick. They listened to you. They saw the cast. They said, okay, Nick doesn't think we should give that up. And Respa, actually, Plazebo goes up with the Ying ultimate to try and sustain her teammates, activating that global healing, giving her the ability to support all of her allies everywhere. But it doesn't seem to have lasted long enough with Thiel in the back line. And now Faenex is his next. He's going to go down. That's the damage over time. It's going to secure the kill. A double kill for Thiel. They cannot, and they do not, and maybe they will not have an answer for his Fernando.
Yep, so pushing in now is Burrito, and in sight for this first number game here. Kings of the North trying to get out of base, trying to make the stabilization play, but Thiel's already in their face once again here. Menchmeyer's not going to be able to get set up. Here comes the Dread Serpent in the back line right now. Faenex able to find a double kill response there. Thiel busy with Menchmeyer, lets his teams fall down. GodWillKill picks up Laizy. Very, very clutch stuff coming out from Kings of the North here, and they're able to hold.
I love the way, and he just goes back and he heals up. He's got veteran. That health pool's going to be back up in just a second. He sticks himself back into combat, though, but he's still got some extra healing because Spunky's giving him some hookups. He's got the voodoo magic hookups, but he's back in the fight, full health. How do you deal with this, Nick? They just don't have any closing power to get rid of what is being a very hard carry with a large health pool.
They could have realized there that that was their window to take out Thiel right now. A nice hook is going to drop the shield there.
Nice shield.
Thiel's falling lower and lower, but these Mending Spirits are keeping him alive. Menchmeyer, though, able to close out the kill. Ancient Rage comes out on the front line. 26 seconds remaining, and Burrito is finding themselves on the back foot.
Look at this, man. It seems like GodWillKill is standing on ledges. So this turtle hook, can son. Climb all of a sudden. He misses the hook, but a nice shield is going to save him from Laizy's first shot, which would have done quite a lot of damage. He knows he wants the hook.
Ooh,
and actually, Thiel, he knows that too well. He's like, I've hooked too many people on this map.
This
I'm going to go the other way, buddy. Yeah. Thanks, but no thanks. And now it looks like it could be Laizy's turn. A nice kill on Plazebo is going to actually take down Laizy. And there it is. GodWillKill still alive. The Ancient Rage isn't available, and so he's going to go down.
Over time now for Burrito. They were in such a good position here, but great holds coming out from Kings of the North.
No.
But now Burrito starting to win this fight. SunCommander taken down in response. Menchmeyer trying to do what he can, trying to make the plays for his team. Almost has the lockdown available to him, but will fall before able to get hit off. So overtime still continuing to kick here. We have Thiel still alive. Nice reversal from Bird. We'll give him the cooldown back once again. He's able to turn around, find the assist onto his teammates. Laizy and Thiel looking to close this one out.
There it is. The overtime still ticking, though. And it seems like Burrito are stopping away. The ice storm is going to do it. And this could be the end of the game. And there it is, Burrito closing things out over Kings of the North. 1-0 for the European leaders here at the Champion Circuit.
Such a great game, though, from Kings.
Such a fantastic game.
I love it.
I love this game.
Quality assurance specialist.
But no, real talk. Kings of the North coming out in that game, swinging that time.
That's
finding
true.
Multiple team fights in a row there, pushing their advantage when they needed to. They were able to stall out Burrito there at that last choke for, like, what, north of a minute and 30 seconds?
Absolutely.
Almost 2 minutes?
Absolutely. It seems like their game plan changed. They knew that they gave it up a little too easy going in that first round. And now they decided, we're going to make you work for it. And they did. They absolutely did. They stalled it into overtime. And all of a sudden, that... We're laughing at it. All of a sudden, it ends up working out for them, but it's a little too late, unfortunately.
Yeah.
And so as we get into the end of the score stream,
tell me
what happened here, Nick, looking at these stats.
Menchmeyer stepping up for Kings of the North, in my opinion. 1,400 credits, almost the most in the game there, surpassed only by Thiel on this Fernando there. Able to get so many credits just for doing damage, always being on the objective, always doing what he needs to do. But Menchmeyer did a great job kind of holding down the front line there.
He absolutely did. And you see, also, there's a lot of potential, I think, for the side of Kings of the North to have a more successful game next round. I think they just got to mix up a couple of different things. And I think when they're able to do that, having a little bit more pressure on the Thiel, they're going to have a much more successful match. As we get into the picks and ban stage for game number two.
Taking a look here over at the map screen real quick. Jaguar Falls. Gonna be game number three here.
Okay.
This is when we are in loser's pick. So this is Kings of the North map picks here. No surprise. Everybody knows what to do, where to do it on this Jaguar Falls. Everyone's so comfortable with it. We're gonna go see what team comps they elect to bring to the table here. I'm looking for something spicy at a burrito. Give me something.
I need a meatball here. And Burrito, they're looking to pick something up. This could be an interesting pick. The Eevee worked well for them. The Kanessa worked well for them. But the Fernando, that's what it is. He comes in right now. That's what I was anticipating. The Fernando, it is just so strong with Thiel. And now Kings of the North are going to have to deal with it one way or another.
So many people can play this pick on Burrito here. We've seen Laizy on it. We've seen Thiel on it.
Mm-hmm.
I think we've even seen Bird on this pick there. So that opens up everyone else's champion pool. You have no idea where they're going with this comp because it's flexible. Everyone can play it there. Kings of the North going to respond with a Ying Drogos, though.
That's a nice composition there. Getting, again, the Drogos, they love that. Also taking it away from Spunkki, but he doesn't seem to be caring about that. He's going for the Maldamba, and now the Makoa, the Barret could come in here. This could be bad if they go full
Are they
tank
going for the record speed win here?
With Maldamba. Okay. It's the Eevee. The Eevee. Nice.
Going to be Eevee there. So likely to be, what are we thinking here? Thiel on Fernando, Laizy on Eevee, and then probably Bird on Makoa?
Yeah, Bird and Spunkki. So if they give Spunkki the Maldamba again, it'll be interesting. They take away the Barrack, which is strong. You have to select your front line here. Otherwise, you're left with Ruckus if they're able to go ahead and secure the Barrack after they've taken the flank. I'm sure Burrito would have taken Barrack, but they wanted to secure the Eevee, and they wanted to secure that big flank damage carry for Laizy. So Barrack, Cassie going to come in. Another direct damage. They've got three direct damage now and one blaster on the side of Kings of the North. And now here it is on the side of Burrito. They go with Victor for their first.
Wonder who's going to be playing that. SunCommander probably likely be taking up arms as the Victor here. Okay, so this changes things.
So we'll probably end up seeing SunCommander potentially on
probably
the Androxus.
I think he's going to stay on the
Victor. Stay on the Victor?
Maybe. No, that's a good point. He hasn't played the Andro yet today. This is last chance to dance.
Yeah, he's going to be.
Or SunCommander. This is Burrito's final game potentially of the champion circuit.
And the Bomb King, the Bomb King coming in, though, Nick, at the last pick for Kings of the North. Talk to me about this selection and how that might impact the game.
It's super hit or miss, like we saw when Kamaker picked it up in the first series there. The Bomb King only pulling 20,000 damage in a rather lengthy game there. So if you're hitting the shots, you know, Bomb King, one of the most dangerous picks in the game. You know, given perfect accuracy, given all of that, if you're hitting your shots, Bomb King is deadly.
Absolutely. And so let's see if Faenex can do the terribly heavy, lift the terribly heavy load that is on the side of Kings of the North to go ahead and try and secure this final game of the set to make it an opportunity for them to come back and reverse sweep this. But they're going to go against Thiel on Makoa, Spunkki on Eevee, Bird on Androxus, SunCommander on Fernando, and Laizy on the Victor.
We were way off there. See, this is what we were talking about, though. Everyone on Burrito, it feels like, can play almost every top-tier pick.
We've seen Laizy on Fernando.
And it makes it so difficult to figure out what they're trying to accomplish with their draft phase, and I think that's one of the real advantages they have in the scene right now.
And SunCommander on the Fernando, and Bird on the Androxus. It's already going to get two kills on the side of Burrito, and this is such a snowball map here. It's going to be so hard with the choke points to get out of this.
Jeez.
Laizy picks up a kill on the Victor, and almost all of Kings of the North are down. The only one alive is Faenex. He's the Bomb King. He's used that Poppy Bomb to get himself some space, but to what avail? His team is down by 12% already.
Thiel going to be looking for a hook onto the high ground here. Jumping, he will find it onto that Barrack, dropping the barricade immediately, but Menchmeyer taken out. The combined efforts of Thiel and Spunkki there on the Eevee, 48% in favor of Burrito right now. They are holding Kings of the North in their spawn.
Nice play.
A man down.
Spunkki on a rampage here already. Spunkki is just having a field day. It's like he just got let out of class. SunCommander's
bored. You can see him emoting there in the way back line there, just laughing.
And it's 99%. That's going to be a captured objective for Burrito. That entire time they were zoning, they knew it was just a formality in terms of time. There was no way Kings of the North were going to be able to get back onto that.
Laizy able to spot out Plazebo there, even hiding in that nice spot with the jump hook. He's going to take SYER off the map there. Thiel with the hotness right now. That is like one of the few hazard zones in the spawn base.
Wow.
Of Kings of the North right now. Laizy, or Thiel, able to find it. Almost gets another one onto Menchmeyer. GodWillKill is here to try and heal him up, but Menchmeyer going to fall down.
Yo, Thiel is so good at this positioning, man.
Oh.
He's going to take him out in the air, but it's a beautiful death because, of course, Placebo is going to take out Thiel as well.
Checking in, still laughing.
Still laughing. Okay, just making sure that Fernando is ready and playing at his highest potential there. Laizy, actually, not on
going,
the Eevee, but there it is. Spunkki comes out with the emotes as well. Burrito feeling themselves this game. They're almost at the final choke, Nick, and it's a minute and 30 seconds left.
SunCommander committing to the BM there, laughing until his dying breath.
That's what it is.
Finding the answer right now. On to Laizy, but Spunky's going to take him down. The Ice Storm and Menschmeyer backpedal straight into it. Double kill for Spunkki right now. Beautiful stuff coming out of him, and he spots another one in the Ice Storm there. SYER gets a double kill, but now is under pressure from Spunkki. But for how long as the Hunter becomes the Hunted now? Spunkki needing to get around that corner. Going to be using that emote to peek.
Using that emote as tactical BM, and now Kings of the North. They've got the Drogo's ultimate.
Ooh, careful, son.
The ultimate from Faenex for the Bomb King is potentially there. It's going to be a damaging kill onto SYER. Laizy collapsing off the Makoa pool from Thiel, who's just been unstoppable thus far. 47 seconds left on the clock. It's 1-0 for Burrito, and they're looking to finish this off as the Dragon comes in, trying to stop the onslaught of pressure that has been Burrito.
Jeez. Dragon Punch going to miss. Laizy going to take Plazebo down as he found himself a little overextended without getting a kill there. GodWillKill retreating right now, but under pressure from Thiel. Ancient Rage is available.
Nice
we
bait.
Will see it come out. He will take out GodWillKill. SYER able to answer. Double kill now for Thiel here, getting closer and closer. No one is there to stall this out for Kings of the North, and Burrito going to take this one up 2-0.
Oh, and just the sprinkles on the cupcake. Thiel's Makoa is becoming something of legend here. He is really so comfortable with his champion. The laughing from Fernando. They are just feeling themselves. And Burrito, why not?
They deserve it, man. Dominant performances all throughout the summer circuit, now through the champion circuit. Just feeling so good. I hope that they keep their head on straight, though.
That's
look
right.
Forward, you know, keep grinding here because the big tournament is still coming. They have already qualified for the Hi-Rez Expo, and they want to win it. They are hungry.
Yeah, and I think this is more of a I want to be noticed on screen rather than I really want to make the other team feel horrible. Because, of course, you know, Kings of the North, they haven't won a series yet in this champion circuit. They're looking to change things here. They've had a couple of nice defenses, but they just haven't been able to deal with the combined pressure of the Fernando on the side of Burrito and then all of the other carries doing so much work. SYER, he's going to dodge roll, but he's going to dodge roll into a bomb.
Yeah, taking that barrage there. SunCommander finding Faenex in the back line right now. This pressure is just so much. SunCommander finding another kill, this time onto Menschmeyer. Thiel takes down Plazebo. Laizy answers onto GodWillKill. Once again, Kings of the North sent back to base as 5.
And they have no way of getting back again. It's 21% on the side of Burrito, but realistically, this is essentially a captured objective unless something unique can happen here. There's 42%, and only one member is on it at this point, it seems. So it is just all of the members of Burrito zoning out, having a blast, while on the other side, SunCommander is laughing on the point.
Thiel just sitting by that hazard zone here, looking for another hook off the map.
He
will pull the dragon out of the sky there. One more shot will do it, but the thrust able to save his own life. The shell spin is going to be good to get Thiel out for the time being. Laizy picking up Plazebo. Bird finds SYER, and Spunkki picks up GodWillKill. A nice ice storm in the back line. Menschmeyer is caught between a rock and a hard place, and the turtle will take him out.
I love the aggressiveness by Thiel, just the right time. He knew he didn't have enough health, but right when Menschmeyer got to that low threshold, he felt comfortable. He jumped in and decided to help his Androxus out. Faenex has not had the impact he's wanted with the Bomb King, and again, I don't know. Bomb King is a very hit-or-miss champion when dealing with some of these higher-level pros. You've got to be so good at landing those bombs.
Yeah, we've seen District 69 and Burrito don't even really pick it up, maybe just because they respect the pick, the difficulty that it takes to pull off here. You know, this is a flavor pick, comfort pick for a lot of other teams there, but they rarely go after this Bomb King.
I think it is. You mentioned a good point. I think it is about the difficulty that Bomb King has. As Faenex goes down the field again, it's so much easier to execute the damaging combos with a lot of these other champions. You even look at Drogos, who is a blaster, right? You look at this point being pushed again, it's almost game for Burrito, but with Bomb King, he can do what Drogos can do, what Bomb King does with area pressure, so much easier. And there it is. That's the kill.
GodWillKill falling off the map there. Just a capstone on a nice play there. Capturing that final conversion is Burrito. Going to be taking game number 2.
Yeah.
Or three.
Three. I believe that's going to finish things out. Yeah, that's going to be it. And so Burrito actually end up cleaning up the set against Kings of the North. Again, we were talking about the Bomb King, but really it just didn't work out too well in terms of the picks. The Kinesa early on, I mean, it was so dangerous what everybody was able to do on the side of Burrito. It's just been a very fun showcase of one of the best teams in Europe. And as you see, 4-0 sweeps on the side of Burrito for every single game.
Yeah, I've just taken out every single, not a sign of hope for Kings of the North right now. But that is going to be the end of this second set. But that's not all the action we have for you today.
No, we've still got another set left, and it's going to be an exciting one as well. We're going to see the second place team in Europe, D69, get it their chance to show, hey, we're worth talking about too. And I'm sure they're going to bring out some exciting things. We've got Bugsy, Sheepa, Perdoe, Elven Path. We've got all of these great players that are going to be highlighting themselves versus D69. And they're going to be taken up against Kings of the North. So maybe Kings of the North, they'll get a win today. We'll see. And we'll see you all in just a few minutes for that game 3.